Manuel Ugarte is on his way to England to sign for Manchester United and will complete his transfer in the next hours. This is according to ESPN Uruguay. The long negotiations for the 23-year-old have finally reached a positive conclusion, pending successful completion of the formalities. ESPN write that it's a fact Manuel Ugarte is leaving Paris Saint-Germain to become a new Manchester United player, sources confirmed to ESPN. The 23-year-old Uruguayan will travel to England in the next few hours to join the Red Devils. Ugarte will become United's fifth senior signing of the summer, after Lenny Yoro, Joshua Zirkzee, Nusa Mazraoui and Matthijs de Ligt. United fans will be on the lookout for possible sightings of Ugarte, who has not featured in either of PSG's matchday squads to start the season. It's common knowledge the Red Devils are in need of reinforcements in midfield after a mixed start to the Premier League season. Ugarte could be the answer. Manuel Ugarte's style of play is just what Manchester United need to offset the decline Casemiro displayed last season. Ugarte will help young midfielder Kobbie Mainoo and play a key role in shielding a defence which faced too many shots last season. United agreed personal terms with Ugarte back in July to the excitement of supporters, but the clubs have struggled to agree a fee. ESPN have not disclosed the final transfer fee for Ugarte. PSG have stubbornly demanded a fee in excess of 60 million euros, which United have felt is steep, especially as the player is no longer part of head coach Luis Enrique's plans. Part of the delay in negotiations seemed to hinge on the negotiation of a loan deal with compulsory purchase to overcome United's complicated flirtation with profit and sustainability limits. However, the imminent sales of Scott McTominay to Napoli and Hannibal Megri to Burnley are seen as having freed up cash so that a straight purchase would be possible. The deal should be completed in time for Ugarte to feature against Liverpool on Sunday, although with little football under his belt since the Copa America, it is unlikely he will start the game. Meanwhile, Manchester United owners Ineos are pushing ahead with a series of player sales which are bringing in key funds to the club. Every year, Manchester United fans hear about an impending clear out ahead of the summer, and rarely does it happen. In 2021, for instance, United managed to accrue just £16.5 million in player sales, a paltry figure. This summer, United are on course to achieve a record amount in player sales, which could end up smashing through the £100 million barrier. Manchester United have sold a high number of players, which could rise as the transfer deadline approaches. Donny van de Beek, Willy Kambwala, Alvaro Fernandez, Mason Greenwood, Aaron Wan-Bissaka, Facundo Pellistri, Will Fish and Maxi Oidel have all been sold. A £25.4 million fee has also been agreed to sell Scott McTominay to Serie A side Napoli. The total figures from these sales, not including add-ons, is an impressive figure of £79 million. Include potential add-ons for Donny van de Beek, Mason Greenwood, Facundo Pellistri and Will Fish, which total £21 million and the total sales could accumulate to £100 million. Many of these United sales also include high sell on fees, which could yet provide valuable further income for the Red Devils. The Manchester United's £79 million accrued in player sales, pending confirmation of the McTominay sale, makes this the second highest total in the club's history already, and the top spot is already in reach. United's last summer, United sold impressively, with Dean Henderson's £20 million exit making up almost a third of the £63 million total. The 3 years previous were far lower. Summer 2022 saw the club bring in just £26 million. In 2021, United only sold Dan James for £25 million, and in 2021, sales reached just £16.4 million. As Manchester United continue to reshape their squad, the financial impact of these player sales cannot be overstated. The sales not only help with financial fair play regulations, but also provide the funds needed to bring in quality reinforcements like Manuel Ugarte. With Ugarte on the verge of signing, United's midfield will receive a significant boost, something that has been much needed after a shaky start to the season. The club's strategy under Ineos appears to be working effectively, with record-breaking sales bringing in nearly £100 million. This is a stark contrast to previous summers when United struggled to generate substantial income from player departures. One of the most notable aspects of this summer's sales is how they've managed to offload players who were once considered key figures in the squad. Players like Scott McTominay, who has been a consistent presence in United's midfield, and Donny van de Beek, who arrived with much promise, have now been moved on to make way for new talent. The same goes for younger prospects like Hannibal Megri and Facundo Pellistri. who, despite their potential, have been sold to generate the funds necessary for United's ambitious transfer plans. The departures of Aaron Wan-Bissaka and Mason Greenwood, two players who at one point seemed to have a long future at the club, further underline the extent of the overhaul taking place at Old Trafford. Wan-Bissaka, once seen as a key defensive asset, and Greenwood, whose career took a dramatic turn, have now been moved on as part of the club's strategy to build a new, more cohesive unit. As the transfer deadline looms, Manchester United still have some work to do. There are ongoing discussions about the potential departures of Jadon Sancho, Victor Lindelof, and Christian Eriksen. If these moves materialise, they could push the club's total sales well beyond the £100 million mark, setting a new record for the most lucrative summer in United's history. This aggressive approach to both buying and selling players signals a clear intent from Ineos and Erik ten Hag. They are building a team that can compete at the highest level both domestically and in Europe. The influx of new talent like Ugarte, combined with the departure of players who no longer fit into the club's plans, is designed to create a more balanced and dynamic squad. Looking ahead, United fans will be keen to see how these changes translate on the pitch. The pressure will be on Erik ten Hag to integrate these new signings quickly and effectively, especially with crucial fixtures against top teams like Liverpool on the horizon. Ugarte's arrival in particular is expected to bring much needed stability to the midfield, allowing players like Bruno Fernandes and Kobbie Mainoo to thrive in their roles. With just days left in the transfer window, the focus will now shift to finalising any last minute deals, both in terms of signings and sales. If all goes according to plan, Manchester United could enter the next phase of the season with a stronger, more balanced squad ready to challenge for silverware. Ineos have shown they mean business in 2024. If you're excited about the future of Manchester United and want to stay updated on all the latest transfer news, squad developments and match insights, make sure to subscribe. Join the conversation. Let us know what you think about the changes happening at Old Trafford. How do you see the new signings shaping our season? Drop your thoughts in the comments below.